He's sitting on a fence like that. He did butt in at one point.
Scab?
Asked the man with jolly eyes, tilting his head. Oh, we can just walk up here. Okay. You're hazy on the notion of a scab. Smells like politics, though, Rhetoric says. Maybe it's got something to do with flasks, with the flask he reaches for from time to time. What exactly is a scab?
A kind of a worm, content with mere survival. They come, they want to do our job for shittier pay, screwing over both themselves and us. Everybody loses.
Hold on, where did they all come from?
Beats me. Somewhere in the ground, I think.
You don't seem to like them much.
Gotta be bloody stupid or freaking evil to scab. Or I guess, scared, maybe. But scared of what? Of who?
He looks at the mass, squinting his eyes as if trying to ascertain what they're scared of.
Personally, I'd rather beg than scab. If the gentleman shouting on the street came begging, maybe they'd have gotten something.
Have you tried talking to them?
We've explained the matters, but they don't listen. This lot would be reasonable and go home if the big guy wasn't riling them up all the time.
He shakes his head. Logic says, big guy. He means the leader of the scabs. I'm not a scab. I'm a cop.
Kai was just messing with you. No one's ever seen a cop scab.
His smile deepens his wrinkles even more.
Imagine, you cops going on a strike, but then another cop comes in and says, let us cop for less money.
He chuckles, then realizes.
Speaking of, what brings the RCM here? To the Wild North. Come to see the strife?
Oh, is that him? I've come to Martinez investigating a murder. Murder, huh? That sounds like a lot of hard work. You'll never see me investigating a murder. Maybe you want to help me solve it by telling me who did it? Of course, Policia. He gives you a sly smile. It wasn't me. You can rule me out. Easier that way. Drama says he didn't do it. It's the truth. Hey, you're the man in boots at the gates. Kuno said you know about the armor. Huh, he smiles. The little boy I did good on his promise. His promise? To get me into trouble. To sick the pigs on me. Pardon the choice of words. Not mine. What happened? Kim asked. I was asked to look into the armor situation. Official Union probe, you know. Track it down. See who took it. Did you? At first I thought, why not? Maybe the pieces can feed the strike? Buy us a few more days under the sun, you know. So I went to this boy. He said he'll make me his prison, bitch. He's got eyes everywhere. The cops in his pocket. And the king, he's the king of Jamrock. Serves me right for doing menial footwork. I dropped that probe right then and there. It still got me into trouble. He smiles. One bad move is all it takes. So Kuno used us to, what, scare you? It's a minor nuisance. It's all good. He contemplates taking a swig from his flask. The probe into the armor. What did you learn? I learned that people don't want to talk to a drunk Union man about some armor. What else? Not much. Technical stuff, mostly. That was the interesting part. What sort of technical stuff? I did some research into this armadura. Let's say I have friends at the library. He explains with a wry smile. I didn't get into the material science, just how it comes off. How does it come off? In parts, four in total. The helmet was the first to go. The kid says he tore it off and kicked it into the sea. I believe him. The boots were still on the guy last I saw. Too hard to remove. So, as I count, there are two parts missing. The gauntlets and the cuirass. This is where I left off. Too much hassle. More like a job for some militia. Hold up. Four pieces. Helmet, cuirass, gauntlets, boots. What about the leggings? Oh, they're just gone. They don't exist anymore, if they ever did at all. He gives you a jolly shrug. Forget about them. I did. I'm ambitious. I'm going to find all of it. All the pieces. All of it? Lieutenant raises his brow. There are some junior officers out there eager to prove themselves. I will leave some for them, but okay, let's find all of it. Rhetoric says it's implied he finds it unlikely that you will succeed in this. A Mesquise epic, then. All across Martinez. He lances south, where the canal runs. I hope it will be a real bonanza for you. Thank you for the cooperation, sir. No problem. He finally takes a swig from the flask. If you see that kid, thank him from Call Me Manana. Thank him for showing me the way. Empathy says he is sincerely grateful he is not tracking down pieces of armor right now. What's the strike about, anyway? You know, serious business, he smiles. I'm sure the big boss would be glad to tell you. You'll have to ask him first. Suggestion says he's a chatty guy, wants to talk about the strike, return once you've met the union boss, and are on a better footing with the organization. I'm looking for assistance with a dead body situation. Body still hanging in the tree? He rubs his chin as if pondering his core beliefs. Aye, that's a rough pickle. Can't help you with that, sorry. I'm not really an admirer of dead bodies. Might be someone else from the union can render assistance, he shrugs. Does this mean you can let me through the gate? I don't operate in that capacity. I'm not a granter of passage. He takes a swig and points up the stairs with his flask. The passage grants itself. Logic says it's so simple. Why did the scab leader warn you of the guards blocking the way? That's simple? I just walk in? Aye. Walk right past Measurehead and go on in. Past Measurehead? Yeah, the 2.5 meter tall Seminese supremacist there. He points to the bridge above the gates. Walk right past him. Right. Then press the button to unlock the door. Uh-huh. Then go past him again. Okay. And you enter the harbor through the office. Esta. So you're saying it's actually quite difficult. Don't worry. I'm sure it's not completely impossible. For example, you could best Measurehead in a physical confrontation. Or you could convert to his Seminese supremacist worldview. Or, he strokes his mustache. Maybe it actually is completely impossible. Has anyone here ever bested him in a physical confrontation? Not yet, no. He fixes his eyes on you, evaluating your prowess. He's incredibly strong. Has any of the scabs tried converting to his worldview? Jean-Luc himself would say the philosophy had proven overly heroic for the scabs to convert to. Not enough intuition. Got it. Another thing. Sure. The man whistles a jaunty tune, the wind rustling his whiskers. I'm a bit short on money right now. Can you spare some of it? Sure thing, my friend. I can help you out. He flips a coin toward you. Try to catch it. Okay. Not completely even, but... Fail! The coin narrowly slips by your outstretched fingers and falls to the ground. Oh, I'm sorry. Didn't mean to throw it like that. It's a thing we harbor folk do, passing around cargo and such. He rubs the back of his head. It was not meant as provocation or ridicule. Lieutenant Kitsuragi picks up the coin and turns to you. Okay, I was afraid it would fall through some slat and then go down to the people below. Appreciated. Alright, we got a dollar, or 1 real, whatever. Right, always glad to help out the RCM. We're in the same branch, you and I. Humans, I mean, not slithering scabs. Nice talk, gotta get moving. Well, I don't think I can best that guy in physical combat. You're taking food out of our mouths. Find all the armor pieces. You want all the armor pieces. Deck yourself out in full metal, battle-hardened glory. Note, this might take a while, like a long while. Right before the end of the game. Where's the rest of the armor? Kuno lied to you. Return and confront him. Okay. I look forward to that with bated breath. So we can get a little bit up there. a notice. In case of a strike, press button behind guard. A hermetically sealed door, locked by electronic means. There's no lockpicking or door kicking this one. It says nobody comes close to... Measurehead? You're the right stuff, Measurehead? The future belongs to Measurehead. Just look at him, the wonderful hunk. So that's Measurehead. Hello?
Your buddy betrays your degeneracy.
Okay.
Yeah, Measurehead. His body totally betrays his degeneracy.
The young woman at the giant's side agrees. Authority says, don't say anything, size him up first. Say nothing, size him up first.
Are you admiring my morphophysiology?
A ripple of muscle passes underneath his skin. He lets you look.
It must be frightening to stand in the shadow of this racial pinnacle. Be calm, I'm sandwich. You are not in danger because you are not a threat to me.
He called me a ham sandwich. What do you mean my body betrays my degeneracy?
You have succumbed to a ghoul.
His face contorts in disgust as if he was smelling a dead rat.
You reek of it. An invisible sword of a ghoul emerges from your throat. You cannot see it, but others can. It is making the woman in my company sick.
Wait, Al Ghul?
Yes, Al Ghul.
Logic says he means alcohol. Do you mean alcohol?
Correct, my small skull self.
He nods approvingly.
Al Ghul is an ancient Ilmaran toison. A parasitic fungus that has colonized your race. It is a trick the desert pygmies played on you, for humiliating them and stripping them of their land.
I'm glad I can read along, that's all I gotta say. Encyclopedia says, intentionally fermented drinks have existed for 10,000 years. The Ilmarian people did not invent alcohol, it's existed since the Neolithic.
This is a fabrication the alchemists of Yizot and Bashir and the Holam and Hul have fed your people. Go on believing in it, race loser.
Race loser? I don't think that's how history works.
Why don't you have another drink? Your features are not yet congenitally deformed enough.
Oh yeah, Measurehead.
The babe looks at him with eyes full of admiration that transcends the merely sexual. Smell my breath. Kim, is it really so bad?
It's not good.
Perception says, it's like a rat crawled into your stomach, got drunk, and drowned. I just drink a little on the weekends. You're right. I'm a servant of Al Ghul, but I still need that body down from the tree.
No, you don't. You need to get another drink.
I do?
Occidental Aplo Group B4 is done giving orders around here. The influence of the Ham Sandwich race is waning.
Again with the ham sandwich. Authority says, show him the ham still got it. Authority, what do you exactly want me to do here? Rhetoric says, does this remind you of someone? The guy down there. You're just him after pumping some iron. You know, I really... That's pretty accurate, I think. Actually, I think the ham sandwich Ray still has it in him.
Willingly calling yourself a ham sandwich, how far the Occidental Hablo group has fallen. You were once a noble and powerful race.
He pauses in melancholy reflection.
You gave the world eugenics, electricité, and powerful weapons of war like missiles and aerostatic aircraft. You made great gains in metallurgy, race theory, and statecraft. You dominated lesser cultures, like the deformed Hemians and the inexplicably potato-obsessed Quakers.
Quakers.
But now your ascent to the genetic summit has halted. You are obsessed with sadness and with frivolous pop culture.
Sadness?
You will be superseded. Isn't that right, babe?
It is, baby, yeah. You know it.
She doesn't have a single working... part of her brain. I don't know. Interfacing says there is a button right behind him, just out of reach. It must be the one that opens the door to the harbor. Yes, I know interfacing, but it is, like you said, out of reach. Suggestion says, this man is not budging. Let's hope his superiors inside are more cooperative. I'm not pushing him out of the way. It was your people who put that dead body up there. Your people should help me get it down.
Enough with this begging. You should leave the stage of history with dignity by inviting the other races to a great world war.
A world war?
Bring your troops to the Seminine Islands and to Boogie Street, and we will pulverize you. When you are gone, we will build a museum for you.
How generous.
The walls will be lined with bottles of Al Ghul, your beloved beverage. Inside, we will store the oaths to homosexuality you call art, and your microcephalic skulls.
This guy for real. Rhetoric says there may be a peaceful solution to this. You could internalize Measurehead's race theory. He would take you as one of his own. Wouldn't that mean I have to become a Seminese supremacist myself? Why, yes. Why don't you want to be a Seminese supremacist? So what if you're not Seminese? You can be anything. Good chance with that. Very low. Knocking him out. Could you imagine if I could actually... You know, I bet even if I succeed in this, I won't succeed in it, if you know what I mean. Why are you not with the Hardy Boys? Okay, I'm not going to try to talk like he does at all. I am not the first line of defense. I am the last. He looks toward the coast defiantly. In addition, these so-called Hardy Boys are an effeminate clique of bodybuilders. Their company is spiritually degrading. This guy is surprisingly intelligent. Drama says, you pick up on something artificial in his tone, like he's putting on an act. This is unlike him. He is usually more himself. There's more to it. What have you got against them? Fine. They have recently fallen under the influence of a possibly sexually perverted female vagrant and a narcotics peddler. It's shameful. Who do you mean? Find out for yourself, endomorphic blob. Interesting. The lieutenant takes a quick note. Do you know anything about this mug? He does not so much as glance at the object. Know anything about it? Stop showing me your pathetic cup. I have no interest in it. Drama says he had nothing to do with it. What are those tattoos of yours supposed to mean? Racists are generally not very good examples of their race. He gestures toward the lorrymen down the street. I am not like them. I am craniometric perfection. I have taken the trouble to permanently draw a phrenologic grid on my skull and features. This should dispel any doubt. Visual Calculus says, the drawings are precise and look true to their pseudo-scientific ambitions. One thing, however, is not entirely free of throwbacks in the phylogenetic tree. His large jaw, for example, could be a trait indicative of criminalism. Also, his earlobes could be smaller. Are you sure? I mean, that jaw is clearly an atavistic stigmata. Okay, the babe says the atavistic stigmata makes her parts say yes plenty. Oh, look at that. I got a better chance. I plus one bested him in craniometrics. Babe, thanks. The tattoos on his stone face briefly form a smile, but I got this. Your earlobes are too big. The size of the earlobes is not a real craniometric criteria. Everyone knows this. Your earlobes are flawless, Jean-Luc. Yes. The man falls silent, his face motionless. You sure I'm not craniometrically superior to you? You exhibit forward projection of the jaw, indicative of schizophrenia and sexual inaccountability. From a purely aesthetic standpoint, the dimple in your jaw makes you look like a baby. That is not craniometry, that is just an observation. What else? It is impossible to see any more of your bone structure. It is covered in the ravages of Al Ghul. From what remain of your features, I can see fleshy lips, baldness of the head, and long arms relative to lower limbs. This leads me to conclude you are not a police officer, you are a common criminal, an offspring of murderers and sailors from Surla Clef and Vesper, and possibly even the degenerate sheepherders of Ubi. Interesting, so one of my ancestors was Surla Clef and the other Vesper? Your racial heritage is uninteresting. It is the same as all Revacholians. Your parents and their parents made the decision to reproduce while under the influence of Al Ghul. That is the only reason you are here. You serve the Union, don't you? Aren't they white? Don't be vulgar. White or not has got little to do with this. The race enigma runs much deeper than that. He turns his eyes toward the harbor, seemingly bored with you. Authority says there must be some friction there. He's keeping it well hidden, however. Yeah, but you still serve them. How does that factor into your life? Mr. Clare is a man of vision and means. He has the will to confront polycultural capital, something your race, naivistic communist, never did. Also, to serve is noble. It takes discipline. Your petulant individualism has only contributed to your race failure. It is lax and moronic. Individualism is my jam. Jam, individualism. You have gotten these ideas from degenerate youth culture, have you not? You have picked them up from rock and roll songs? I have gotten it from disco, actually. Offshoots of the Seminese people invented disco while having sex under the influence of cocaine. It is a shame upon my race, but what is done is done. I am not surprised you enjoy it so much. This has happened to many of the side products of the inevitable cultural victory of the Seminese race. Okay, I'll ask, who are the Seminese? The South Island race, haplogroup A4A. We are the rightful masters of the Insulindian archipelago. We descend from the Areopagites of ancient Paracarnassus, and arrived here 4,000 years ago, millennia before you. We are the future. This is all you need to know. So you were born and raised on the islands before you moved to Revachol? I am a descendant. The narrow streets of Ulanbur are with me in my genetic dreams. I see young Seminese women walk into the gray mass on Ile de Fantôme, waiting on immaculate conception from the pale. So you did not come from the islands? No, he cranes his head. I have heard about it. On the radio. So you're not really Seminese, you're just from Revachol. I am from Kuron, he changes tactics. And no, it is not just in Revachol. This city is central to the Seminese strategy. Spreading through its trade networks, our culture will dominate the world. You've heard enough about our phylogenic secrets for today. You have extinction to come to terms with, and never getting that dead body down from the tree. Okay, Kim, what do you think about this? I think this racist is better than the last, but the next racist will be the really good one. What? Conceptualization, that will be the... That will be our lucky racist? He will grant us 3 wishes, Kim says. Your pedomorphic friend has quick wits, he leans in to inspect. A protruding occiput and an indented zygomatic bone. The lieutenant does not flinch. You should keep him close. The congenital defect of farsightedness does not render him a complete invalid. He still has the use of his mind. Let's try this. Subscribe to his advanced race theory. Success. Ask what kind of races are there first. Classification is core to this stuff. Measurehead, I am new to this world. Help me understand its races. I need to know what kind of different races are there. Do you? The lieutenant looks at you. Whisper. This is for the thing. The lieutenant looks toward the harbor's electronic door and then to you. He lets out an audible sigh. You are obviously a liberal, Sealite, the man tells him. A polyculturalist. I can see it from your love of microtechnology and your sartorial choices. Do not deny your friend the truth you have denied yourself. Drink. There are 3 categories of race. Type A, the heroic races. Type B, the servile races, and the vile CF race, Cauldron of Pederasty. Which one do you need education on? Type A, heroic races. These are the Seminese, the Aeropagite, and the Occidentals, excluding the Mon, of course. The Mon are riddled with eczema to the point where they find it impossible to smile. They are all lactose intolerant, a common result of inbreeding. Lactose intolerant, really? A receding genetic pool has led the Mon on reprehensible street parades in Mon cities like Stadskanaal and Redefort, wearing wooden clogs on their feet and little green tassels on their hats. Wait, who exactly is a Mon? Are the Mon? You know them by the names of their nation-states, the Orignes, the Gottwaldians, and the Konigsteiners. My people simply call them Mon. Encyclopedia says, Mon is a derogative term for the first world people of Gottwaldian descent. They do not all have eczema. Also, people of Katla, the Suru, and the Uhu are much more lactose intolerant. The wooden clogs, though? In some municipalities of Aranye, people do wear shoes made of wood to street parades. Green, orange, and even yellow tassels have also been seen on hats. He continues, the Mon are proof that you can have too much Occidental racial purity and tassel-centric culture, really. Inbreeding has led to a lactose-intolerant sub-race whom no one can take seriously. Okay, got it. Then who are Type A, then, in your view? The Vespertines and the Messinians of Vesper and Messina, the ancient Meteorans of Meteo by the Golden Pisantic Sea, the Serens of Serla Clef, and even the North Konigsteiners all have Type A race propensities. God. I don't have to remember this myself, right? There's no way I'm gonna retain all this. The other large Mondial civilization, the Mesk, are too yellow and oleaginous to count as a heroic race. True, they have a violent and expansionist... but they have a glandular problem. He draws his finger across his face. Overproduction of sebum. Sebum is leaking into their brains, making them listen to El Mariachi music and eat toxic minced meat-based food, which in turn only produces more sebum. And who are the Semenese and Areopagites in this? As proven by the Mon and the Mesk, Occidental Type A is in retrograde. The Semenese and the Areopagite are on the ascent. And the Semenese are? The indigenous people of this, the Insulindian archipelago, the Semenese inhabit the southern islands. He gestures toward the south, across the ocean. I am Semenese, from the stock of Ulanbur on Ile de Fantôme. And the Areopagites? They are the master race of the Ilmarin deserts. The Semenese are descendants of the Areopagites. We came here during a heroic migration from Ilmara to Insulind, thousands of years before the lactose intolerant, mon ridden Occidentals discovered this place. Why is he so focused on them being lactose intolerant? Who gives a crap? Rhetoric says, wait, didn't Lilmarian desert pygmies invent alcohol and get pillaged just a short while ago? Weren't the Ilmarians pillaged by my people and then Al Ghul happened and all that? No, those were scimitar-wielding race losers of Sarava, Yisut and Bashir, with their Himi servants. Big difference. The Areopagites were fasting and conquering while this happened. You never penetrated the western dunes. Jean, baby, you're on fire. The young woman looks adoringly. Or Jean? Is that his real name? I know, babe. This is when they talk to each other. Well, she doesn't have much brains, and when he talks to her, it sounds like his brains go away for a little bit. Just while he talks to her. What's the difference between the Semenese and the Areopagites? The Areopagites are sleek, long-headed. The Semenese are powerful, mesomorphic. The former is an immutable progenitor, unchanged since the super isola of Paracarnassus. Ancient brains rest in their slender skulls. He falls silent, contemplating the beauty and the mystery. Then he continues. The latter is perfected and adapting. Together they form the Semino-Areopagite or Semiopagite super race. That is all. There are no more Type A races in the world. You know, the fact that this is in caps makes it harder to read these words. Inland Empire says, nature was not capable of more. Okay. Type B. Type B are the unheroic races, amorphous non-competitors of the great race, the Quakos and the Vacholiers. They are mud-colored people. Visual Calculus says, the Quakos of Grad, Yugo, Semsk, Shest et al. Are what you would call white, officer, is in a suspect description. You said Quakos. I've been trained to identify them as white in official descriptions. Yes, to an untrained eye, the Quako appear white and pinkish, like a ham sandwich. But look into their eyes and you will see, he squints, full of sage wisdom, they are of an indistinct color, and so is their skin, unhealthy, muddy, and ashen. Pinkness is a racial quality that has to be earned through centuries of advanced ballistic warfare and cultural domination that the Grad people have undergone for drinking Al Ghul and smoking the degenerate tabac herb and for eating potato. Wait. So you're saying potatoes are bad for you? Bad for you too? The Quako, the countless micro-nationalities of Grad, are all inexplicably obsessed with potate. The only thing they like more is dividing into microscopic ethnostates like political amoeba. Rhetoric says, wouldn't he be one for ethnostates? You don't like ethnostates? They are microscopic. The Semino-Areopagite superstate will cover the entire remaining planetary crust, uninterrupted from Holy Semenine to the boreal plateau of Katla. Its leaders will be the genetic epitome of the Semenese and Arapagite stock, ejected by nature, not the base inert spoilage called Deimos. And the Vacholiers you mentioned? Revacholians, halfway between Type A and the racial cauldron, too mixed to know right from wrong. You tried your degenerate little revolution, which was the single greatest failure committed by humans in our 82,000-year history on this planet. You don't hold anything back. Just tell us how you really feel, Measurehead. Encyclopedia says, is it 82,000 years that we've been recording history? You have very little idea of what is happening, but that seems a little off. I'm pretty sure history hasn't lasted that long. The mysteries of the people of this planet are a tragedy that has played out countless times over, like a fever dream of skin, hair, and bone. Wake up, naive chess piece. I've heard about this revolution. Mistakes were made, but it was the right stuff. You're wrong about it. The revolution came to Revachol from Grad in Sarath-ridden potato carts. It is literally an illness, a prion disease that leaves the parietal and frontal lobe ridden with holes, a soft sponge-like mass of dementia, hallucinations, and paranoia. The revolution is fatal familial insomnia, a hereditary prion condition passed from the Quaco to the Occidentals. He pauses in theoric self-reflection, but not sexually, probably through trade routes and potato acid, the prime component of the potato plant. Enough of type B mediocrity, he nods, satisfied with the outcome. Okay, then the vile CF race cauldron of pederasty, please. Type C through, C through F are a museum of failed chimeric experiments and tragic maladaptions. They are tortured creatures waiting to be put to sleep. Your morbid interest in them worries me. I don't want to worry him. It's supposed to ascribe to his theory, right? I've been challenging him on a couple things. Yes, better not to go into it. It would be cruel, the man agrees, to entertain ourselves with their deformities. Were there any able-bodied races you need education on? Well, now that we've been through all the types, do I understand advanced race theory? You understand nothing. To solve the great race enigma, you have to first ask yourself, what is the race enigma? You have not even worded the mystery, let alone solved it. Will you help me get that body down if I do? We will see. Kim says, access to the Union is important for investigation, but there may be another way in without becoming a race theoretician. A speed of course says, am I mildly worried he might take it seriously? The lieutenant thinks, yes, I am. He concludes, I am worried. Wait a second. Do I risk alienating Kim then? Well, it's going to bring a thought into a thought cabinet, which we can or cannot take. Which we may or may not take, more like. How do I word the mystery? New task. What is the race enigma? You need to internalize what you have heard here today, then return to me. This clarity does not come instantly. Let's discuss something else. I cannot possibly imagine what else we have to discuss, Type B Revacholian. Your love for disco music and venereal disease? Let me see something. That's a pry bar, though. Everyone should try to be more like Measurehead. Work out a lot and get tattoos.
The unpromising race pupil returns.
So, by holding this pry bar, I don't get any closer to being able to knock him out. I mean, it's possible. I could actually succeed. I've succeeded at things lower than this. But that's like death, right? What is the race enigma? Put the advanced race theory into a free internalizing slot in your head. If there are no free slots, free one up. Then pass some time, when it's internalized, return to Measurehead. This is how thinking is done. A mass of fantastic races swirls in your head. Desert pygmies playing with their own excrement. Koikos juggling potatoes. Eczema-ridden Mons grinning and dancing on wooden clogs. Everyone is there, the whole race gang, plus some that you may have come up with yourself. The thieving sub-kips and the seolite casts of fortunates hatching some kind of scheme. In the eye of this race Imperion, a vertigo reaching up to the heavens, you sense something drawing nearer. Nearer. Well, I'd have to get rid of one of these things. Or get another slot, however I do that. Minus one drama, forget it. Fooled by the absurdity. I gotta try it. This is probably unofficial, guys. I dream about you all the time.
The unpromising race pupil returns.
17. I mean, it could be worse.